Hello friends, welcome to bispsolutions.com. My name is Sumit and I've come up with a very interesting requirement in wave analytics. And that topic is selection binding. We have already saw how can we perform selection binding in wave analytics, but that binding was only from a single data set. This time in this video we'll be going to see how can we perform a selection binding using two data sets in wave analytics. So let's switch to wave very quickly, and I have got two data sets, mainly account and sales data. And just keep this in mind that if you want to perform selection binding based on two data set by using two data sets, so we should have at least one common field between them, then only we can perform selection binding. For example, I click on accounts, and in this accounts I have got a column called account name. And in same manner, I click on sales data. In sales data I have got a column called account name. So you see, in both the data sets we have a common field named as account name, and by using this I would be going to perform the data binding. So let's begin. How can we do this? So I create a dashboard, and I will also be going to tell you that why it is required. So for example, I create a new step by using sales data, and I just filter sum of or count of stars. So let's suppose I say sum of price, and I group by account name and click on done. When I drag and drop this, I can simply change its visualization and apply a list filter, and this list filter based on account name, and make sure that this is from the sales data, sales underscore data. So I select account name. Let's do some massaging to this. Some customization. First, I changed the major fields as none. I don't want it to be display count values, and I just drag and drop it here. Now, when we preview it, if we apply filter, so filter will be applicable onto this widget. I click on ABC, and this will display records only for account name ABC, ECME, ACME, BISP, and so on. If you want to remove the filter, I just select that record again and the filter will be removed. In continuation of that, if I create a new step, this time I'm using account dataset, sum of annual revenue, and I group by account name. So we have got a lot of accounts, so no worries about that. We can filter or we can set the limit, but I'm not going to do anything. I simply drag and drop onto not this one should be named. So it looks pretty scrum, means it looks pretty messy because there are more than 1000 records. So we can apply filter onto it if it is required, but let's leave this part as it is. We'll see the actual requirement. Now when I click on preview, and when I applied a filter on ACME, this ACME exists in both in my sales underscore data as well as account in account data set. And when I select ACME, it will only update, it will only reflect this first chart, first widget. It does not make any changes in the second chart. So my requirement is by using the same filter for which is coming from, which loading the values from the sales underscore data, so it should reflect the other data set as other widget as well. So let's have a look how can we do that. So this can be done by using JSON customization. So I press Control E. Before that, I'm going to save this just in case. So I'll just save it and give name as data binding and stored under my private app. Then I visit JSON, and in JSON we have three steps: name underscore one, account name two, and account underscore name one. This account underscore name one is for widget one. This is for the selection list, and this is for the third, the widget or the second chart, second graph. Now, what we will be doing, the selection one, the selection step is this account underscore name two, and this would be getting data only from sales data. So I scroll down first of all and copy this account data set and paste it along with here. So now this selection list would be, can be associated with the second data set as well. So in same manner, if you want it to be apply filter on other data sets as well, we need to simply copy paste the data set's name. This is mandatory. And I remove this aggregate flex, otherwise it won't work. Let's done it. And you'll see we are getting an error message that sales underscore data is missing from data set. Might be you will get this kind of error. So what you can do is, I'll just scroll down and I'll just copy sales underscore data and paste it. And you see, when I saved and click on done, it is resolved. Now let's have a look, it works or not. So I click on preview, select ACME, still the first widget is reflected, the second widget won't get affected. So still it is not bind, because still now only first widget is binded with the selection list. This widget is not binded, so we need to bind it. And for binding, let me arrange it side by side so that we can see the output when it gets reflected. And one more thing, I'll just hide the legend. I don't want to show legend. Same for this, I don't want to show legend because I know that is sum of price. It's showing sum of price and sum of time. We get back to JSON. And then the selection on step. This one is for the second widget. So we have group name. So what I did, I applied a filter, and to apply a filter, I remove this group because we are not using groups now. I'm using only measures and filters. So within query, I write filters bracket comma and make sure JSON is in a proper format. And I would like to apply a filter on name, and the value will be coming from double quotes, double bracket, it should be column, and value is from the selection we made in account underscore two. So whatever selection we made in account underscore two dot selection comma we need to use escape characters here, and it should be account name. So make sure that all the fields and labels are case sensitive, so it should be in same manner. So we have double quotes, column, account name underscore two dot selection comma, square bracket, account should be double quotes, then square bracket close, round bracket close, and I remove this dot as object, and it's a function. That's all, and we click on done. So it's done now. That's the code which we need to write. Let's click on done and preview it. So by default you can see only one value is coming, that is the total sum, that is this much billion. When we preview it, and now as soon as I made a selection, I select ABC. Now when I select ABC, no result is found, because in sales underscore data we have ABC account name, but ABC does not exist in account, so that's why no result found. But when I select ACME exists in both the data sets. So there are 2 million records for ACME, and there is sorry, there the total sum of annual revenue is 2 million for ACME, and the sum of price is 120 in sales underscore data. So we can use this functionality in multiple scenarios. So like we have, I have applied this date selection binding on two widgets. You can perform the same thing on multiple widgets. This we need to keep in take care of the selection. So that's all in this video. If you have any queries, you can write to us on www.bispsolutions.com. Keep watching. Have a nice day.